Hello friends, my name is Viraj. Today I would like to talk about the functionality that is sp underscore help and sp underscore help text in SQL Server Management Studio. So let us begin with our tutorial. So first we will click on our SQL Server Management Studio. Just simply click on it. After clicking that, just enter your username and password. After entering that, just simply connect it. Just click on new query. Here we have already created a database that is YouTube. After that, just click on your database, this plus sign, it will be open, and click on your database that is YouTube. Just simply click on it. After that, here you can see a table. Just click on it, you can see one table is created, that is viewer. Now I have also created few functionality using stored procedures such as insert, update, delete and view. So by using the functionality that is sp underscore help text, you can easily retrieve whatever the procedure which you have written while creating the procedure for the table for various functionalities such as insert, update and delete. So just click on this programmability, just simply click on it. Here you can see the stored procedure. Here I have created a four stored procedure related to the table viewer with the different functionalities such as a delete, insert, update and view. Now we will use the functionality that is sp underscore help text. Now simply I will just simply drag this here. After dragging that, write here simple sp underscore help text. Just simply select it. Here you can see result to grid and result to text. If you select a result to grid, the data or the procedure which you have created will be shown in the grid format. But if you want to be shown in the text format, just simply click here result to text and simply execute it. After that, select this. This is the stored procedure which you have written for creating such kind of functionality data, such as insert functionality, where you have passed four parameters, says vid, vname, vpassword and vlocation. So if you want to, suppose if you want to alter the table or you want to update whatever of you want to add some kind of functionality related to the stored procedure, this is the easiest way where you can get whatever the stored procedure or whatever the flow of the data functionality which you have created for inserting the data or updating the data or deleting the data. So you can easily update whatever sort of thing if you want to insert. So suppose if you want to insert one more parameter, so this is the best way to get your stored procedure by using sp underscore help text. If you want to know about the detail of this procedure, just write sp underscore help. Just simply select it. Here you can see result to grid. Just click on it and execute it. You can see this is the name of your procedure. Here you can see the type stored procedure. Here you can see the created date time when it is created. Here you can see the parameter which are passed for you, for you use for creating this procedure, all the data type, their length and all sort of thing for creating such kind of functionality such as VB insert user. So by using the help text, you get the detail of that stored procedure that you have created. If you want to edit something or update some audio, if you want to add a new functionality related to your stored procedure, this is the simplest way where you just write SPS underscore help text and just whatever the stored procedure, if you want to add it or alter it, just drag and drop it, just select it, here you can see two options, result to text or result to grid. Just click on result to text, execute it easily. Whatever the flow of the code you have written for your this functionalities are shown, just simply copy it, paste it, and just edit it and alter it. Suppose if you want to alter something, just simply add whatever you want to add, and just and here you just write alter, and here if you want to give one more parameter, that is status, where care, just alter it, execute it, the command is completed successfully. So in this way you can alter the table so that if you want to edit some procedure, that this is the simplest way which you can use. So let us check whether this parameter which you have passed now is updated or not. Just simply select and execute it. See, it is been shown your new parameter, that is address status, which we have entered just now. So in this way you can edit your procedure by using SP help text. So hope you like this video. Please like, subscribe and share it, and keep supporting me. Bye.